everyone. We're back today with a trivia episode once again. And we're going to find out if these two knuckleheads know anything about stem cells. The quiz was made by Giuliana's friend and colleague, and she is an expert in this field.
Yes.
Which is stem cells.
Stem cells.
Stem cells.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. And as for the rules, first of all, there are 5 questions, and each question has 4 different answers, or possible answers.
Mm. Yeah.
And whenever you guys want to take a turn, use the squeaky toys.
And trigger my dog, so let's not do it too often.
Okay.
Yeah. Whenever I hear the squeak, I can hopefully recognize the pitches.
Mm.
And if I don't, I'm just going to give the turn to whoever I like the most.
Absolutely fair.
Yep.
Yep.
And if you answer correctly, you get a point.
Mm-hmm.
If you answer incorrectly, the other one gets a chance to answer.
Makes sense.
Yeah. And whoever gets most points at the end wins.
Really? Wow.
Yeah.
That was unexpected.
Hey,
mind-blowing.
Yeah.
Alright. I'm ready.
Right, go on.
Okay, you're gonna lose. Anyways. Stem cells are defined as cells that possess the following 3 properties. They are capable of self-renewal, they are unspecialized, and they can give rise to specialized cell types. However, not all stem cells are identical, and they vary in their differentiation capacity.
Okay.
Now the question is, which of the following statements is correct? A. Multipotent stem cells possess greater potency than pluripotent stem cells. B. Human embryonic stem cells used in research represent totipotent stem cells capable of generating all cell types.
Okay.
C. Pluripotent stem cells can generate into any of the 3 germ layers: endoderm, mesoderm, or ectoderm. And D. Most of the adult stem cells are unipotent, meaning they can generate only one type of cell. Okay.
I know as well. Okay, go on.
It was faster.
Yeah.
So you want to know which one is the correct one?
Yes.
I would say, was it B, the one that embryonic stem cells are totipotent?
Human embryonic stem cells used in research represent totipotent stem cells capable of generating.
That's answer B.
That's answer B.
I would say that it is B.
Incorrect. Do you want to answer?
Yeah, I'm here, Wikipedia.
Can you read me the A again?
Multipotent stem cells possess greater potency than pluripotent stem cells.
This is going to be embarrassing. A.
Wrong as well.
Really?
This is so much fun. The correct answer was C. Pluripotent stem cells can generate into any of the 3 germ layers: endoderm, mesoderm, and ectoderm.
I was so sure that this one was incorrect.
Incorrect.
Anyway, incorrect.
Just
like your grammar. Stem cells are often associated with embryonic stem cells. Some stem cell populations, labeled as adult stem cells or somatic stem cells, can be found in juvenile and adult individuals as well. Now the question is, which of the following statements about somatic stem cells is not correct?
Okay.
Which is false?
Hi.
Ready?
Yep.
A. Stem cells responsible for the renewal of intestinal mucosa reside in specialized niches called crypts. B. In addition to hematopoietic stem cells, bone marrow contains mesenchymal stem cells that give rise to skeletal tissues such as cartilage, bone, and fat. C. Satellite cells are quiescent cells found in mature muscle that activate during injury to give rise to regenerated muscle. And finally, D. unlike other tissues in human body, brain does not contain stem cells and cannot regenerate. Giuliano.
Now.
Yes?
This is going to be very embarrassing for me.
Absolutely.
If I get this one wrong. So, just to make it clear, you want the wrong sentence.
Which one is incorrect?
Can you read... Can you read the last one, just to be sure?
D.
Yes.
Unlike other tissues in human body, brain does not contain stem cells and cannot regenerate.
The brain, parts of the brain can produce new neurons, so I'll go with D.
You're correct.
Oh, my job is saved. Oof, okay.
Yeah, if your boss saw this quiz, you would be fired.
Yeah, that was the one that I was thinking as well, but I wasn't fast.
In 2006, Shinya Yamanaka introduced a method that allows reprogramming terminally differentiated somatic cells into pluripotent state using a combination of four transcription factors, now termed Yamanaka factors. IPSC, derived from individuals with clinically relevant mutations, are now routinely used for disease modeling.
Mm-hmm.
The question is, which of the following patient-specific IPSC lines was the first one published?
I thought it was going to be what are the four factors, but we looked at each other like, ready?
Which one's the first one published? Yeah. Okay.
Your friend was kind.
I think I can just leave the thing there. No. Okay, go
Come
on.
Come on, try.
All right, go on, yeah.
Okay, A, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, or ALS. B, juvenile onset type 1 diabetes. C, Fanconi anemia. Or D, cystic fibrosis.
Just so that you don't get a turn.
Okay.
So what did you want to know again? Like, you wanted to know which one of these was what?
Which of the following patient-specific IPSC lines was the first one published?
I don't have a great reasoning behind my answer. I am guessing that probably that it's possible that diabetes was like a better known disease already back in the day when they first started doing this kind of research. So maybe they started...
2006?
Oh, well, the date was 2006. All right. Yeah, sorry. The question was so long that I forgot the context. I was thinking of more ancient times. I'm gonna say fibrosis for some reason.
That is incorrect.
Damn.
Giuliano, do you want to take over?
Not sure. So
A, B, or C?
ALS,
diabetes, or anemia?
I mean, I don't know about Fanconi anemia. Anemia is a problem with the red blood cells, and they don't have a nucleus, so that makes no sense. I'm thinking maybe
this is going great.
I would go with A.
A. Yeah. ALS?
Yeah.
Correct.
Whoa! Bum!
Calm down, bitch.
Yeah.
IPSC technology
The question is, what Vera was about to say.
What has Vera been smoking?
Yes.
Anyways, question number four. IPSC technology revolutionized stem cell field by overcoming major ethical issues associated with the use of embryonic stem cells and also paved the way for personalized medicine. Mm. Yet no IPSC-based therapeutic applications are in use, and there are only a few ongoing clinical trials. The question is, why are stem cell-based treatments approached with caution? And here are the answers.
Mm-hmm.
A, pluripotent stem cells are potentially tumorigenic. B, proper integration of transplanted stem cells into target tissue poses a challenge. C. There is still high variability among differentiation methods, and proper standardization of protocols is yet to be established. Or D. All of the above. Nicola?
I have a hunch.
I think we're gonna go with the first
one. I think it's gonna be all of the above.
Yeah, I was about to.
You are correct.
Yes, at least one. Thank you
for Okay, so we have 2-1.
Yeah, out of curiosity, you did tell her not to go hard on us, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's nice.
But she said, I mean, yeah, well, yeah. I know, she did.
Thank you, Giuliano's friend.
Since this is a final question, I'm gonna give 2 points if you get it right. So both of you do have a chance to win this. Even if the IPSC-based therapeutic applications remain to be fully established, IPSCs have proven out to be a valuable tool for disease modeling, toxicity assays, and drug screening. The question is, which of the following studies involving IPS technology has not been published? Have you read your things? Okay. A. Cardiotoxicity screening of cancer treatment using patient-specific iPSC-derived cardiomyocytes.
Okay.
Myocytes.
Yeah.
Myocytes.
Myocytes. What did you say?
Cardiomyocytes. Shut up. Cardiomyocytes. Do you want me to reread the question?
I think it was wrong. Yeah.
We didn't get it anyway.
Yes, exactly.
Cool beans. B. Generation of pancreatic organoids with proper cellular composition of both endocrine and non-endocrine cells and islet cytoarchitecture. C. The use of brain organoids to study the cause of Zika virus infection-induced microcephaly. Or D. Amelioration of cellular and physiological markers of aging using partial reprogramming with Yamanaka factors.
Well, we know that that's for sure been published.
Yeah. So which of
these,
which of these has not been published?
Tell you what, I think I have a half-assed reasoning here.
Cool beans.
Right. We know about about answer D. At least we think we know that.
Yeah. Let me guess. I think I'll catch you with that one.
That D has been. The study that you're talking about in answer D was actually published. Mm-hmm. And then I have a feeling, like a faint recollection of maybe hearing something about the study that you were talking about in answer B, which was the one about organoids, right?
Pancreatic organoids.
Yeah, that's B, correct?
Yep.
Right. So, I mean, I would say that B and D are out of the question. And I find that it might be that in this particular question the Zika virus can be just a clickbait, like the one that, you know, it's been all over the news like in recent times, so it's just there to catch your attention. I would say that that's the wrong answer. So like that's
so your
one,
answer is C.
Yeah, that's the one that hasn't been published.
I would have gone with that one as well.
You're wrong.
Thank you, because I would have gone with that one. So if that's wrong, I have no idea.
Oh well.
Wait.
You're welcome.
You do have your chance.
I know, but I would have gone with the C, Jesus. Okay, so we have, I would also exclude the D for the same reason that he said. I would have excluded the B, but not anymore. So we have cancer. So, I mean, B.
Your answer is B.
Yes.
Do you lock it?
Yes.
You're correct.
Whoa!
Calm down, yeah,
there you go. You get to keep your job, I suppose.
Yeah, you get to keep your job, and you have 4 points. 4 points.
4 points?
Yeah, because he got 2 points for the last one.
All right, that's correct.
Yeah.
Do I get any points for that?
Saying that's correct?
Yeah, no.
Thank you for
no,
that.
No!
Thank you for
lost.
That help.
Anyways, thank you
I'm
to everyone.
The editing.
And if you want to see more quizzes like this, or just videos in general, please click the subscribe button. Like the video,
share with your friends.
And comment below about how stupid you think these two are. Or if I mispronounced something terribly and these guys didn't correct me, tell me. Because I probably did.
Alright.
Anyway,
see ya,
bye.
Bye.